Okay, we're at the Manchester Institute for Health and Performance, MIP, and I'm joined by Chris Jenkinson, who's here getting his boxing medical done today. Great to see you, Chris.
Yeah, it's good to see you as well. My medical today, I'm here for my 10th time, my 10th scan, hopefully, you know, no changes or anything, and I do my last year and get to the 100th fight, and then, you know, the doors will be closing for me.
Yeah, you're tough, but is that your plan, Chris, get to the 100th fight and then call it a day?
Yeah, definitely. You know, if I didn't get to it this year, I think this is definitely going to be my last year anyway. But the last 2 years have been really slow burners. But you know, if I get to that 100 this year, hopefully, you know, fingers crossed. And it'd be definitely the curtains on my career, and you know, move on to something else.
You're on 86 fights now.
I'm on 86 now. Yeah, so I've got 14. I've been averaging, you know, 14 to 16 a year. So hopefully we'll get there.
Well, looking at your box rate, you've got four lined up.
I have, yeah.
For February, March. Yeah, two in February, two in March.
I have, yeah. And funny enough, I've just bumped into one of the lads who I'm boxing in March. He's a nice lad, but you know, we'll see on the night.
Yeah, it was quite uncanny. You sat opposite each other in the reception, having a chat there.
Yeah.
I think it was quite surreal for him, because he's a young professional, isn't he? For you, you've seen it all, done it all.
Yeah, Chris Lamb said, oh, you're boxing a kid called Sam Spooner. I said, oh, yeah, that's in March, that one. And then, little did I know, he was stood next to me. Lucky I didn't say anything stupid.
Yeah, fighting talk. But, you
know, yeah.
I said, then, did you do an head-to-head in the reception?
Should have done, yeah. Promoted it a bit more.
Would have been a good picture. No, Chris, you've 86 fights. You've bought the T-shirt, as they say. You've been round the block. You're renowned for a fight that'll go in with anyone at a short notice. You're giving these young up-and-coming pros who are sold all the tickets and have got the unbeaten records, you're giving them experience and, you know, journeyman, on the road, whatever other names you give it to, it's an hard way to make a living, and I'm sure you know everyone in the boxing game respects your type and what you do. What keeps you going, Chris? What keeps you going every weekend to get in and, you know, crack the boards with these young up-and-coming lads?
It's just, you know, it's just the love of the sport, really. You know, like everybody, I started off, you know, selling tickets, and it's you know, with a lot of lads, I don't think that this is like did start off to go on the road. I think that just happens with you know, when the ticket sales start falling away and stuff like that, and that's what happened with me. And you know, now I just I like to go out there and, you know, give lads a test and. You know, it's a test for myself as well to see where I'm still at, and I believe I've still got this last year in me to get to that 100, and that's a new goal for me now to get to that 100 and come out of the game, you know, with all my faculties and 100 fights on my record.
When you said that when you started off, you went the typical way. I'm gonna get everyone, my mates and family, and sell tickets to people who can come. At what point did you realise that, actually, and when did you know you actually could go on the road and earn a living from it as being in the away corner?
I think in my second fight, I took an away fight in Sheffield against a kid called Ryan Hardy. And I think it was a right barnstorm, and I wobbled him, and I went in there to finish him off, and he dropped me. So it ended up being a score. I lost by a point. But if it wouldn't have been for the knockdown, I'd have won by a point. So that's how close it is. So, yeah, it's just, you know, I took it from there, and just, you know, if the fights got offered, you know, I'd take them. You know, if it, you know, I had a few warm fights in between as well. So I was just in between, and, you know, I enjoyed it, whatever side I took, really.
Well, there's a real knack to doing what you're doing as well. I mean, people use the words like survive and that kind of thing, but I think it's a bit more than that. You know, you've having these skills to match these lads who are prospects and have, you know, got a lot behind them as well. So, you know, it's there's a real knack to what you do.
Yeah, of course. You know, there's definitely a skill behind it. You know, you've got to learn how to, you know, to tie and hold and move and you know, faint with your feet, you know, faint with your eyes, faint with your head, faint with noises, anything like that. You know, to just buy your seconds, because every second counts in there. And a lot of the top guys who've been on the road will tell you, like the likes of William Warburton, Christian Leite, you know, that's who I picked it up off. You know, it's every second counts, and it really does when you're in, especially with these top guys. You know, like some of the lads I've fought. You know, just to name a couple, is Ted Cheeseman, James Metcalf, Denton Vassell. You know, it's tough at times, and you've got to learn them tiny little tricks of the trade, what will buy you that second. And yeah, it's because it does get tough at times.
And you pick them up as you go along, obviously. I think they say that you don't realise how long 3 minutes is until you've been in a ring. You know, it's a bloody long time.
Oh yeah, so it's a very long time. And it depends what type of opponent you've got. If you've got a pressure fighter, then you need to pull something else out the hat sometime. And it's good to have all them little tricks of the trade in there, because you all these guys who decide to go on the road or they end up on the road, they'll need them at some point.
Do you enjoy it, Chris? Do you enjoy being a boxer and living it out as a journeyman?
Yeah, I wouldn't be doing it if I didn't enjoy it, because it's a hard game, as everybody knows, if a bad injury occurs, it's, your career's over and your life's over. It's one of them things. So yeah, if I didn't enjoy it, I wouldn't be in it.
Mm-hmm. And what do you do in the day when you're not boxing?
I work with my brother tiling, floor and wall tiling. So it is a tough job in itself. So it doesn't take me long to get sharp. So I do a lot of training myself to keep sharp, and then I go and do my pad work and stuff like that, and my tech work with another place.
I suppose you're fighting nearly every week. You're fit anyway, aren't
you? Well, that's like you're sparring anyway. Yeah.
Yeah. So 100 fights, you reckon you'll get that in this? You need another, what, 14? You got four lined up?
10. I've got four lined up. I've worked out I need to be, at the summer break at the end of July, I need to be on around 95, and then 5 or 6 after Christmas. And then hopefully Steve Wood will put me on his Jolly Boys for me under a fight.
I'd love to
have that. I've always wanted to fight on a Jolly Boys show.
I've
never been on it, but to have me under a fight on there, I'd be absolutely perfect.
Come on, Steve, sort it out.
Yeah.
You mentioned there some of the names you've been in, good names who have gone on to become champions, and some of the prospects who were on the way up who were highly touted. You know, some of the names when you think, which are the ones that, I mean, you mentioned Denton Vassell and things like that, you know, proven fighters, but any of the young pros coming through over the last, say, 2 or 3 years who you fought, who you think are a little bit different and special to the rest?
Definitely. The one name that does stand out soon as you ask me that is a young Irish lad called Dylan Moran, who I fought at the Bowlers Arena, and it was debut, and he come out and he threw absolutely everything at me. And like I said before about knowing all the tricks of the trade, he was a pressure fighter, come forward southpaw, and if I wasn't in the condition I was in, I'd have definitely got stopped that day.
We'll look out for him. I was saying about the respect that you get in the game as well, and do you feel that? Do you feel like it's you really give your dues to the sport and other journeymen who do this?
Oh, definitely, yeah. If it weren't for the guys like me and the other lads out there, you wouldn't have these prospects coming through and learning what they need to learn and picking up the rounds they need to and progressing onto that next level.
Yeah, well, Chris, it's great to speak to you. Well respected in the game, and it's great what you've done, and you're a tough man. Always come to fight and giving these lads the experience they need going forward. So great to see you, mate.
Yeah, good to see you as well.
Best going forward and get that 100 fight. Hopefully, I can get to you.
Thank you very much,
Jolly Boys. God bless you, mate. See you soon.
See you soon.